Alright. Welcome to Sven Salon's Let's Play Stardew Valley, Spring 28 of Year 1. Things are going pretty good. You notice over 60k for money in the spring. We're on the last day. Sitting on almost 30k. Which is great. That's 10k higher than the minimum I wanted to have for blueberries. Learned to cook omelet. That's nice. So, what we're going to do on this day. I don't really need the torches anymore because I got a glow ring, which will eventually be replaced by an iridium band. These will probably get changed with the season change, but I can get the setup going anyways. Right. And one more down here. This will be the pattern. It's going to be the 200 blueberries. Just make a bunch of those. Only need two, but that's okay. I have them for future use. I water that one. Okay, that with me just in case. So, the plan for this last day of the season is to get 300 wood and go build that bridge. Then, I'm talking about the bridge on the beach. All those items that are going to be waiting down there. Then I'm going to go up to the mines and hopefully get 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 40, 50, and I'm going to have 50 gold ore is the hope. 50 gold ore should get me enough sprinklers to do all 200 blueberries on the first day of summer. And have them be watered by the sprinklers. All goes to plan, that is. That way I should only have to do a minimum amount of tilling and watering for those 200 blueberries. I can spend whatever extra money I have to get other crops going on that first day. And then woohoo! Off to the start of a very profitable second season. Oh, there's a book. Oh, I didn't realize in the recent updates they changed it where you didn't have do the journal trick. I missed that. Really? That was the only things over here? Okay, so not really worth. Usually, by the end of the season, there's a bunch more of these. But I have it there for the summer anyways. Start of the summer, there'll sometimes be a few. That's annoying, because yesterday when I glanced, aquamarine was... sea urchin. The purple thing. Sea urchins. There was a sea urchin visible there. So I guess they actually despawn. I didn't think those things despawned over the course of the season. The other times I've done this where I've been there on the 28th, I've had a huge number of them sitting there. Maybe that was just luck of the draw. Alright, well, let's get 50 gold. Or... I don't know why I said that so silly. You might be wondering why I'm sort of hitting these and not the others. They give a point to the XP. Any gold up here? Level for spring. Okay. And I just hit it, so. Level per level for all of spring. Maybe I'll be able to keep that up a little bit in the summer, but it quickly slows down. Especially since farming will not go up for at least like 5 or 6 days in summer. Since there's only go. Literally, that's gonna push me behind the curve on that one. So, perhaps it'd be possible to move like foraging or combat or mining up on those early days. So, yeah, that's not really a challenge that I give myself over summer of keeping one per day. At that point, things start to really slow down. Behind the amount of gold I was hoping to get on this day so far. Got 5 more floors to refill my bars. Thank you. be a cabbage. Does this mean I'll probably have to do some watering next season? The first day? Yeah. That's not the end all be all. I was going to do watering regardless, because I was going to plant as many seeds as I could kind of manage. Summer will be starting the next day. Sleep. Well, I'm one for one. I'm not gonna have my character go to sleep until hopefully those gold bars are done. It reaches like 11:30, 12-ish. Walk it off. Over. It's not a lot of filling. As long as all of these are just wilted crops that may be scythed. Here's my axe. That's not where it's supposed to be. So, sorry if this is a tad boring. I'm just waiting it out. While we wait it out, I'll clear a little bit. Of course, a whole bunch of these will pop back up as the season changes. See you guys. Summer, day one. Leveled up foraging though. We're gonna take fighter because 10% more damage is better than. It says 50% more crit, but that isn't like, oh, you were 5%, now you're 55. Because whatever percentage it was is now 50% higher. It ends up not being a huge benefit. Not like it is a big increase compared to what it was. But I've seen several people run the stats on it, and it turns out to be better to take the attack damage. Especially since that leads to another attack damage increase on that line of the tree. So, I will see you guys.